Hi friends, welcome to Computer Exams Material channel. So in this video, we'll see how to get and set the name of a thread. Okay, how to get and set the name of a thread. So whenever a thread gets created, right, a user defined thread. So whenever a user defined thread is created, so it has a default name. So what will be the default name is thread hyphen index. So this is how the thread name will be if we don't set any thread name. Okay, this is how it looks. So where index is nothing but it's an integer number starting with 0. So the first user defined thread name will be thread 0. Okay, and the second one will be thread hyphen 1, and that's the third one will be thread hyphen 2. So we can set the name of the thread using the setName method. What is the method? SetName method. By using setName, okay, and by passing the string name, we can set the name of the thread. Okay, if we want to get the name of the thread, we can directly call getName. So the default thread name can be changed by either using the time of thread object creation using string parameterized constructor, or after the object creation using above set method. So while creating the thread itself, at that time only we can give the name, okay, by passing the value, or after the object creation also we can set by using the set method. Okay, by using this set method also we can do that. Let's see the program with an help of an example. So let's create a class called ThreadName Demo. Okay, what is this? ThreadName Demo. And I'm just saying public static void main. I'm just writing the main method. Okay, public static main method string args. So this is the thread name demo main, I mean which has a main method, but we should have a thread class, right? So just create one thread name class. Okay, this should extend thread class. This should extends is the keyword. Okay, extends thread class, and then here just override the run method. Override what? Run method. In this run method, what we can do? We can say system.out.println. Okay, thread is available in java.lang package. Sorry, not here. Just print the, not here. So here just system.out.println name of the thread equals to get name. Okay. So when we call get name, it will give the name of the thread. Okay, so what this will do, let's see, returns the thread name. Get name will return the thread name. So it will simply returns the thread name. Now go to the thread name demo and initiate the, okay, just create an object for thread name. Thread name t equals to new thread name. Then what we need to do, we need to call t dot start method. What should we do? We should call t dot start method. Now run the program and see the output. It should give the default thread names. Okay. Name of the thread is what? Thread hyphen 0. Let's put this in loop and see what all thread names we are getting. Okay. For int I equal to 0, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus, And now let's run the, so I'm putting this statement in the loop to see the, to see the values, to print the, to get the name of the threads in the console. So name of the thread hyphen 0 hyphen 0 hyphen 0. So just we are printing it 10 times the same name. Now if I want to change the name of the thread, what I'll do? Initially what it will do, it will give you default name. Now I am setting the thread name. T dot set name. So I am saying it, this is my thread, or customized thread, so this will be the thread name, and after this print the start, just call the start method after this. Now so before giving the name, we'll print the value, and after giving the name we'll print the start. Let's run the program and see the output. We are getting thread start, thread start exception, illegal thread state exception. Why? Because since we are starting the thread twice, so that is the reason we are getting this exception. So instead of that, what I can do is I'll print the, so as soon as I created the thread, right? Here only I'll print the name of the thread, just to know what is the name of the thread before calling start method. I'm just saying t dot get name. Name equals to t dot get name, customize thread, and then t dot start. So now the output should be, first time output should be t dot get name means what? It should give you default name. And when we say t dot start second time, it should give the name of the thread, which is customized thread. Let's run the program and see the output. So first it is name thread 0. This is the default thread. Why? Because here we haven't set the name of the thread. So as soon as the thread got created, what is the name of the thread? Thread hyphen 0. Here we'll get thread hyphen 0. And after that t dot set name customized thread. So now the value of the thread will be, name of the thread will be customized thread. So this is how we set the name and get the name. Suppose if I am not setting the name of the thread, I am just calling t dot start. But what I'll do is I will create one more thread object here. And I'll say it as t1. Now I'm calling t1 dot start. So first I have called t dot start, and then I have called t1 dot start. So the name of the thread is, here I'm printing the name of the thread. Or here also I'm printing the same. I'll just comment this and let me run this program. T dot start and t1 dot start without setting the name. Again we are getting the exception. Let's see why we are getting. Why? Because here I have mentioned t dot start again. I should remove this. Let's run the program. You see here thread 0, thread 1. I think I can give you the example like this. This is a simple example of multi-threading, and where we don't know the order of the threads. So if you see here, the output is first thread 1 and then thread 0, again thread 1. So it's not like 0, 0, 0 and 1, 1. Ideally for first thread it should be thread 0, and for the second thread it should be thread 1. But since we have created thread 0, don't assume that, we have created thread 0 first and then thread 1. Don't assume that the output will be in the order. Why? Because in the multi-threading, it all depends on the thread scheduler, which thread should get executed first. Okay. So this is the best example I can say. We cannot predict the output, or we cannot predict the order when we have multiple threads. So we cannot say which got executed first. Okay. Now what I'll do is I will set the name of this thread. T dot set name equal to thread one. And for this second one, what I'll do? I'll set the name of the thread to thread two. And now let's see the output. Now the output should be what? So before calling the t dot start and t one dot start, we are setting the name of the value of the thread or the name of the threads to thread one and thread two. So now when we run the program, we are printing the name of the thread. So the thread name should be what? Now it should be thread one and thread two. Thread one and thread two. Thread one, thread two. So if you see the output, we cannot predict the order. It all depends on the thread scheduler, which thread should get executed first out of these two threads. Hope you understand this video. Thanks for watching this video. In the next video, we'll see what are thread priorities and what is the default priority, min priority, and max priority, and all those. Hope you understand this video. Thanks for watching this video.